But why, some say, the moon? Why choose this as our goal? And they may well ask, why climb the highest mountain? Well, space is there, and we're going to climb it. And the moon and the planets are there, and new hopes for knowledge and peace are there. And therefore, as we set sail, we ask God's blessing on the most hazardous and dangerous and greatest adventure on which man has ever embarked. For the eyes of the world now look into space, to the moon and to the planets beyond. Man in his quest for knowledge and progress is determined and cannot be deterred. The exploration of space will go ahead, whether we join in it or not. And it is one of the great adventures of all time.
Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed. I'm going to step off the landing. That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Oh, that looks beautiful from here, Neil.
It has a stark beauty all its own. It's like much of the high desert of the United States. It's different, but it's very pretty out here.
Damn, that's got to be Whitney, right? I don't know, I see so many mountains.
I don't know if we can see it like that
sometimes. We're only 20 minutes away from the shooting location. I mean, we should be able to see it, right?
It might be that.
I think it's got to be that one, right? A little hazier than I hoped for. But it did say the transparency was supposed to be bad for a little bit, and then it's going to clear up tonight. So the moon should turn red not long before it touches the top of Mount Whitney. So we won't have tons of time to shoot it. For the red part.
Yeah, just before.
Yeah, not long before.
But it's totally red?
Yeah, it'll be total. You'll be able to see it completely red before it sets. Dude, I think that's Whitney. I feel like it's that way. I don't know. Just the pictures look different than I thought.
I don't think we can see it from here.
What's funny is I thought that was Mount Whitney for some reason. I don't know. So, I think, yeah.
There's like a little valley.
I might need to, actually, let me just walk out here a little bit. Those look prickly. Maybe I need shoes. Good idea. How else am I gonna get tough feet, man? Oh yeah, this is good. This is good. Gotta be that tall one, right? Yeah, that's gotta be it. And that's roughly southwest, so probably just need to move a little further out. There it is.
It's gotta be it.
I think it's that. I'm like 90% sure it's that one. It looks the same. Yeah, it's got that ridge right there. It's got that slopey bit right there. I think that's it. So that's where the moon's gonna set.
What's up, guys? Are you ready for the blood moon tonight? If you're out on the West Coast, out over the Pacific, or in Eastern Asia, tonight there is a total lunar eclipse. So the moon is going to be completely covered by Earth's shadow, and it will actually turn red as the light from every sunset and every sunrise on Earth is projected onto it. So it's one of the coolest sights you can see with your naked eyes. The moon just turns this dark, deep red color. And I am ready to capture it. Look at all of my stuff everywhere. I'm set up here out in the middle of nowhere with all my cameras, and my telescope, my truck, my friends. And I'm looking at a mountain range to hopefully get you a really cool look at this moon when it sets. And it's just gonna be this vibrant blood red. Really, it starts at like 2:30 in the morning, my time, that's Pacific. And it won't be done until sunrise. So I'm gonna have a long night, and I have, you know, a lot of time until it starts, but I like to over-prepare, as you can see. Wish me luck, hopefully I at least get a shot. I hope you didn't capture all that awkwardness. Picked up this telescope on a whim. I didn't know what I was doing. I was just like, I'm just gonna buy a telescope because I'm old enough to throw money away on a toy, basically. I pointed at my backyard and I immediately saw Jupiter. And Jupiter was just incredible, you know, right away you see these cloud bands, you see the moons dancing around it. It's just this incredible sight to see with your eyes. I tried to take a picture of myself and it didn't work. And then, you know, I'm doing some research online, and I figured out if I have a DSLR and I can get like a little adapter, plug it into my telescope and do a long exposure, and then I could see like faint beams. So I pointed it towards one of the only things that only deep space objects I knew about the sky, and that was the Orion Nebula. Orion Nebula is in the heart of the Orion constellation. You can actually see it with your naked eye. It just looks like a little fuzzy star. And I pointed the telescope to that, and I set my camera to take like maybe a 2-second exposure or something. I was able to see this thing through the lens of the telescope. It just looks like this little fuzzy blob with maybe like 4 little stars in the middle. But in the camera, when I took the picture in the camera, it was like blues and reds, and it's like something out of a textbook. There's this incredibly colorful region of space. And I was able to do that with a 10-year-old DSLR and a telescope that I just bought on a whim and I knew nothing about. And I was like, I didn't think it was possible for me to do this. I thought it was just something reserved for scientists and people with billion-dollar budgets and observatories. So at the moment I saw that in the LCD screen in the back of the camera, I was just hooked. It was just done. I was just throw all my money away into this hobby. It's a little more of my full-time job because I like don't play video games or watch movies. When I get an urge to do something like that, I'm just like, let's go take some more pictures. Yeah, it's something magical about it. I'm addicted though. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. It's really special. This is gonna be quite a night.
there's this moment where the moon is going to be completely red, but there'll be like this little edge that's bright, and that's like the money shot. That's my favorite, because you get this really cool like kind of halo effect around the illuminated part, but the rest of it's just all red. Basically about there, gentlemen. Definitely starting to see the red in there. Check out the preview. It's just magical. It's there's something about it when you've got a glowing red moon and just like beautiful stars against a deep blue like velvet sky. It's just incredible. Dan, you should see what I'm getting.
What's that?
You should see what I'm getting. It looks good. It looks good. Look at this. You see that?
I think I did.
Hold on, look.
Yeah.
How cool is that? How cool is that? Look at that, Colin. Yeah, just look at that. Look at that. Just hugging the mountain peak right there.
That's cool as hell.
Damn. God, it's just like magic. It's just straight magic. Oh, so cool. Oh, yes. Yes. Mission accomplished. Yeah, we got it. We captured it many different ways. So, yeah, I'm happy. I'm happy. Ladies and gentlemen, we got him.
Just to take a picture of something like the moon, but show it in a way that nobody's ever seen it. So I think what's so fascinating to me is the fact that all of this is over our heads all the time, but nobody notices. I think that's what's crazy to me, is I feel like I'm just revealing the invisible. And it's like I have a rocket, but I don't need to do that. I'm just sitting in my backyard exploring the universe. I thought, if there's one thing I can do to positively change the world, is get people more aware of how accessible space is and get people excited and passionate about cosmos and science.